I think a lot of things that we did at the Weather Channel, a lot of things that we're doing at the Red Sox, I think you'll have a great appreciation for how they might touch kind of your own businesses as well, and hopefully some of the lessons that we're doing might relate to some of the things that you're thinking about as well. The Red Sox last year weren't the team that was the team of destiny, per se. They weren't the team that everyone thought was going to necessarily win the World Series, but they were a really close-knit group. And they were, you know, we kind of tried to model that within our own technology organization. And so we kind of asked ourselves, you know, would we be considered a championship-caliber IT organization? And I think the answer is no. And there's probably very few organizations that can probably answer yes to that. As analysis and continues to sort of evolve, and as patrons, as fans, we continue to look for more and more information that we get accustomed to, whether it's through football or other sports. Baseball is trying to keep tempo, keep pace with that thing. So this is sort of a bit of a hit, you know, map, if you will, in terms of where the pitch results are going. So we know how a pitcher is pitching. We know kind of where they're throwing the ball. We know what they tend to do on certain counts. What you may not know, and I didn't realize this, is for those that don't know, one of the interesting things about baseball is that you're not allowed to have electronics in the dugout. What you are allowed to do, however, is you can have electronics like right behind the dugout. We spend a lot of time looking at different things, different kinds of technologies to make them a little bit more fan-friendly. This is just a simple example of sort of different kinds of camera technology that we now put up. We have applications that we develop, mobile apps in the ballpark that we are looking to launch for opening day, hopefully, that now tell you sort of like what the wait line is at every single restroom or at concession stands and things like that. And so you can now start to like get to points where you can pull up an application, you can sort of see what the lines are, and it might even say, oh, you know, you might want to go to one on the left because it's significantly shorter. What it does for us from an operations perspective is it gives us a chance to understand the flow of people throughout the park during the course of a game, 2 hours before the game to an hour after the game. And so we start to be able to kind of inform sort of our thinking in terms of how to create a more effective fan experience. Because let me show you a little bit of some of the things that we're thinking about. San Francisco does a very nice job in the area of social media. So they have a social media cafe. So we thought that was so good, we ripped it off into the same thing at Fenway. Or we look outside of just traditional sports. Tampa Bay Lightning, they use a RFID tag, you know, in jerseys that they make available, right? It seems it might be a little big brother kind of thing, but what that does, without having to take things out of your wallet, you can now start to, like, exchange, you know, goods and merchandising and services and things like that by just wearing your jersey. As you look at your own organizations, I mean, I would challenge you, you know, when you're talking to your own technology folks, whether you're here or they're not here, you know, to sort of like look outside traditional products.